fresh start. Better.
Frankie C.
And they say in business, key to success is to use the resources you have. Well, here in Cambridge, we have one resource in abundance.
Cambridge Processor Group. And they build computer systems for fun. Our secret weapon.
Steve Ferber. Could we have a word?
That's him, Roger Wilson.
Spent his summer holiday building and programming a computerized cow feeding device for a firm up in Harrogate.
The computer journals you asked for. You said you wanted all of them.
Thank you, Nigel.
So expensive. But why so expensive?
We must observe the British tea ritual.
So, we all know the MK14?
Sinclair. I saved up for one of his hi-fi kits when I was a kid. Looked nice. Matte black, System 2000.
System 3000? System 2000 was in silver, 20 watts, as opposed to 40 watts in the System 3000.
Whatever it was called, never bloody worked.
Anyway.
We all want to go with the 6502 processor.
Mm-hmm. Of course. It's the only choice.
For the moment.
Plus a whole new look.
Oh, that's right. We start with kits, but we want to market it with a proper, ready-made, moulded keyboard and built-in assembler.
The products we produce are going to be led by you, the engineers.
And so I'm pleased to announce that Nigel will be heading the new computer division. Not just a division, but an entirely new company. Sinclair Computers. A new company, gentlemen. A new beginning. Perhaps we should remind ourselves of the secret of the Sinclair success. That is, being first to market. Letting people know what they want before even they know about it. Now, the MK14 has been a modest success, as I knew it would be, appealing to a specialist interest. And yes, there are companies making more advanced computers, but these are affordable only for use in offices or laboratories. But is the personal computer not a desirable notion? Something every citizen would quietly crave if he actually knew what it was. This is my vision. A computing device in every home in Britain.
I quote,
Personal computers will become steadily cheaper. Prices could drop to around £100 within the next 5 years. Poppycock! Because, gentlemen, we are going to achieve that in a matter of months. Price is the key. Whatever happens, I want a computer that we can sell for the magic sum of £99. At that price, the man on the Clapham Omnibus will want one, even if he has absolutely no idea what to do with it. Beg, borrow, or steal components. But one thing is clear in my mind. It has to look like this.
Just imagine a future where anybody could go and buy a computer kit to program at home. We could sell, what, 8,000, maybe even 10,000 computers.
What programming language are you proposing?
Which one's the best?
They all have their limitations.
Then why don't you write us a better one?
Look, I've heard Sinclair might be developing a new computer of his own. Is that true?
I don't know. We don't speak. Besides, with the team we've assembled, I'm 100% certain that we're way ahead of Sinclair.
Good evening and welcome to the Murray Programme. Tonight we enter the world of the microchip and report on a story of British perseverance and invention. And we ask, will the personal computer be Clive Sinclair's ticket to a fortune? It took Sinclair just 9 months to develop the ZX80, and he began to sell it by mail order in March this year. It costs £99, measures 9 by 7 inches, and weighs just 12 ounces. All you have to do is add an ordinary TV and a cheap cassette recorder. Eventually, there will be some 200 programs available, mostly educational, some technical, and many suitable for children.
Jesus, it's like trying to read Braille through a pair of gardening gloves.
Clumsy programming language. Limited.
Z88 processor. Big ROM. Nice bit of circuitry there. Ah.
Well?
It's like we thought. It's clever. Done on the cheap, but clever.
So, we know what we're up against. We produce something better.
Better keyboard,
bigger memory, smarter chip, and improved language.
I know, but the genie is out of the bottle. He's done it. He's got there first. It's a working computer for less than a ton. It's brilliant. The clear run on us.
Look at the positive. Clive is playing his hand first. If he is bluffing, we will know. If he is holding the full house, we will be able to look through the pack and find the three aces with which to beat him.
You don't play cards either, do you?
No.
So it goes well. We still need to push on. Progress on the ZX81?
First specs are done, and we start work on an initial prototype next week.
What about that bloody screen flicker?
Hopefully not.
Jim, I was wondering if you'd had any contact with Chris.
I'm always in the lab.
I hear he might be going to market with a new product.
Well, I have. He hasn't, I'm not really sure.
It seems a shame he's not still with us. He'd have enjoyed this. That's all.
RAM, twice as much as the ZX80, 8K of ROM, again double what the Sinclair computer offers, and a proper
integrated keyboard that won't give you arthritis. The Acorn Atom is the product that serious computer users have been waiting for.
You seem intent on attacking Clive Sinclair.
That's not personal. It's a vastly superior product, is all.
You're attacking him again.
It's about computers, that's all.
It pains me to say it, but many of these companies won't survive this gold rush in the personal computing market. There may be many clever people in the industry, but business acumen is thin on the ground. Far too much what I call kite flying, that is to say, people announcing products that just aren't ready. But make no mistake, I welcome competition. We are a market leader, but we don't take our position for granted.
Great. Okay, can I ask you about the new RAMPAC attachment?
Yes, well, it was thought that we might do something to boost the machine's memory.
Yes, right, because a lot of our readers are saying that the connection's not that good, that they fall off.
We are aware of this issue. Our engineers have looked into it, and I am informed that the use of a piece of blue tack about the size of a runner bean will resolve the problem.
Blue tack?
Quite so.
Well, that's genius. See, our readers would love that.
Which magazine did you say?
Sinclair User.
Ah, yes, yes. Well, you have my blessing.